we traveled to Emmett, Idaho to visit Chris with Annin Robotics and to see what he's been building. His project, a small robotic arm that can be used for automating a multitude of different applications. Emmett, Idaho is a small agricultural town located in the Treasure Valley. The population as it stands now is approximately 7,000 people. It's about 15 miles from Star, Idaho, and about 30 miles from Boise, Idaho. Emmett, or Emmettville as it was once called, is surrounded by the foothills. In the small town of Emmett, you will find farmers, but you will also find farmers who build robots.
Chris, the property here is just incredible. You got about 5 to 10 acres of field and farmland, and you got the butte here with the mountains surrounding it. It's just so peaceful. How'd you end up finding Emmett, Idaho?
Well, we've been here for a few years now. I had a job opportunity come up for House of Design Robotics in Nampa, and so they gave me a job offer, and before we decided, if this is where we wanted to live, my wife and I just explored the whole area. We went to Cuna, we went to New Plymouth, we just went to a number of places, and we fell in love with Emmett. The scenery here, just with the hills and the butte, we just fell in love with the property here, and Emmett's a great place. The people here are amazing. It's just a great little place to live.
Yeah, no, it's beautiful. And do you have a lot of plans here for the field and the farmland, what you're going to do with it?
Yeah, we spent all last summer putting in all the irrigation and getting this field planted, and this summer coming up, we're going to do this field out here that you see. We're going to get all the irrigation, and then we're going to have horses and cattle.
So you're doing farming by day and then building the AR by night, right?
Yeah, my friends give me a hard time that I'm the robot farmer.
So are you going to plan on putting the AR robot on any of your farm equipment out here and doing some picking and placing or so?
Yeah, I'll have to figure out how to automate my tractor.
As Chris showed me around his property, I was ready to start working on the farm myself. But we had to move on. We headed over to his workshop to see and hear more about the AR robot project he has been building for the past 7 years.
Chris, thank you for having us over with build.video. We're here to see what you're building. This is it, right? This is the hub. This is Annin Robotics. This is where everything happens. We have your parts, your equipment, the AR series station robot. And I've wondered myself, what even got you into wanting to build a robot, basically? What was the thought process behind it? Or were you just sitting home one day and you just decided, I'm going to build a robot?
Yeah, so I've been working with industrial robots most of my career, programming robots for a variety of tasks, and I always wanted to have my own robot. I thought it would be fun to have a robot, that I could use at home for, a variety of things, but I didn't have $30,000 to buy an industrial robot. They're pretty expensive. And I had an idea that I could build my own robot. I was interested in writing my own software. I was interested in learning robot kinematics, and I also had some ideas on the mechanical design. I started out with a small 3D printed robot. I probably spent all of $300 on some components and a real basic program that would just control the 6 axes of the robot. And I wrote a little algorithm to make all the motors work together. And that worked out pretty well on that small robot. So I started building a bigger robot and 3D printing a much larger version of the original robot. I also had a conversation with a colleague, somebody who was he owned a machine shop, and he machined all of my parts for me for my employer for a lot of our robot jaws that we were making. And he mentioned that he had an application in his shop where he was applying a toxic chemical that his employees had to suit up and wear a respirator, and he just didn't like his employees in that environment, and he wanted to buy a robot. But he said the exact same thing. He's like, I can't afford $30,000-$40,000 for a robot that they quoted me. And so I said, hey, I got an idea. I've been working on this idea to build a robot. And I had most of the robot already built, with 3D printed parts, and I showed him. And he was really interested and wanted to start making one out of aluminum. So he started machining all the parts out of aluminum. And I had, put my robot on YouTube. I just put a video out there of and sharing some of my files and my design, and it just took off. People were really interested. I had a ton of people, huge response. And so about that time, he had finished making the aluminum version. And yeah, so that's kind of how it started. And I've just had a huge response and a ton of people that are really interested in, you know, in building this robot.
And the response has really continued ever since. I mean, I go on your YouTube channel and the people just love what you're doing with the robot. I've went on there and I've seen all different type of applications. What are some of the applications that you've seen or that have surprised you that people have been using this robot for?
All of it's been pretty surprising to see what people have come up with. I've seen, people are using it for welding. There's quite a few different welding applications I've seen. I had somebody send me a video of them. They had put the robot inside of a plexiglass box with an ice cream dispenser, and they had programmed the robot to grab an ice cream cone and fill an ice cream cone and hand it to people. Machine tending, I've seen quite a few applications for people using it to tend CNC machines. I've got a friend in California who we actually became friends through our correspondence on the robot, and he built the robot and has it tending a CNC machine, taking parts off of his machine. So that's, and he posted some videos of that, so that, it's gotten a lot of activity in that community. I've seen a lot of applications for people using the robot for cinematography. A lot of people love to use the robot for motion control, for putting the camera on there and getting slow motion shots around whatever it is that they're recording. Biggest thing has been really cool to see is schools using it. I've had hundreds of colleges, universities, they're using this yearly now in their curriculum. A lot of professors have told me they like about it is that they can teach mechanical design, assembly, additive manufacturing with 3D printing, some of the 3D printed parts that are for the robot, as well as electrical wiring, and then all the programming, all the software is all open source, so that gives them an opportunity. So it's kind of an all-in-one package. They can teach all these things with it. A ton of schools using it. There's the NNU project where the students, I've helped them out and donated some stuff to NNU, and they're actually gonna build a reduced size AR robot. I think they're going to call it the AR2.5, but they're building a reduced size robot to fit in the payload for a project that's going into outer space. They're actually going to send a version of the robot up into outer space to do an experiment where they pass a ball back and forth in zero gravity, which I thought was really interesting.
You probably never thought you would end up seeing your robot flying into space, did you?
No, I've been really surprised. I never would have thought half the things people have done with it that I'd see, but the project's really taken off.
That's really awesome. So it's been getting a lot of use in different applications and people are really enjoying it and you can see it. Chris, I appreciate you inviting us to your workshop to see what you've built. And it's really incredible what you've put together here in your workshop with the AR series robots.
My name is Jonathan Herberger and I am a junior mechanical engineering and physics student here at Northwest Nazarene University. So this year, our space project is to develop a robotic system capable of passing a ball while in microgravity. And so in order to do that, we need to be able to adapt to any variability we have in the system. And so we're going to be using artificial intelligence in order to do that.
I'm Aaron Borger. I am double majoring in computer science and computer engineering here at Northwest Nazarene University. And our project this year is involving the AR3 and a miniature version of it. And our hope is to throw and catch a ball in space using artificial intelligence that will learn while it's in space how to throw and catch the ball.
And now for our mechanical system, we have used Annin Robotics AR3 as an example of how to develop and design a robotic apparatus capable of performing numerous tasks. And so it needs to be in a much smaller profile. We have used the AR3 as an example of how we're going to use a similar system when it goes and launches in space. We hope this project will be able to have numerous impacts in both space and here on Earth to help with artificial intelligence in manufacturing, maintenance, and repairs. And so as we continue to develop this payload over the next several years, this first iteration to be launched in August, we hope that we'll be able to provide the industry with some more knowledge on how to use artificial intelligence robotics in space.
If you want to support Chris and learn more about his robot, go to AnninRobotics.com. If you liked this story and would like to see more just like this, future episodes will be at build.video. We want to know what you are building.